Here we have the integral of the square root of the quantity 16 minus 9x squared. So to start, we want to identify what kind of sum or difference we have that we're going to try to simplify. So here we have something of the form a squared minus u squared. And that tells me that I want to use the identity 1 minus sine squared theta equals cosine squared theta. So that's the identity that we're trying to match this up with. So in this case, we have that a equals 4 and u equals 3x. So we have that u also equals a times sine of theta. And in this case, a is 4, so u equals 4 sine of theta. So this means that 3x equals 4 sine of theta. So now we have a direct relationship between our x and our theta. So x equals 4 divided by 3 times sine of theta. And finding the derivative, we have dx equals 4 thirds cosine of theta, d theta. So now we're ready to make our substitutions. So we're going to substitute in for x. X equals 4 thirds sine of theta. And remember, that whole quantity is going to be squared. And we're also going to substitute in for dx, 4 thirds cosine of theta d theta. So making our substitution, we have the square root of 16 minus 9 times the quantity 4 thirds sine of theta, all squared, times our substitution for dx, which is 4 thirds cosine of theta d theta. So now we need to simplify. So bringing this squared term in and squaring everything inside here, we have the integral of the square root of 16 minus 9 times 16 over 9 sine squared of theta times 4 thirds cosine of theta d theta. Our 9's cancel, so we're left with the square root of, so we're left with the integral of the square root of 16 minus 16 sine squared theta times 4 thirds cosine of theta d theta. We can pull out the 16, so we get the integral of the square root of 16 times the quantity 1 minus sine squared theta times 4 thirds cosine of theta d theta. So now we have the integral of, we know that 1 minus sine squared from our identity is cosine squared. So we have the square root of 16 cosine squared of theta times 4 thirds cosine theta d theta. So taking the square root of 16 and cosine squared theta, we get the integral of 4 cosine of theta times 4 thirds cosine of theta d theta. So combining these, we have the integral of 16 thirds cosine squared of theta d theta. We can pull out the 16 thirds. So we have 16 thirds times the integral of cosine squared theta d theta. And now we have a trigonometric integral. So we need to figure out how to solve this one. Remember that our half angle formula, that cosine squared of theta equals 1 plus cosine of 2 theta, all divided by 2. So substituting that in, we get 16 thirds times the integral of 1 plus cosine of 2 theta all over 2 d theta. So this can be written as the integral of 16 thirds times the integral of 1 half d theta plus 1 half times the integral of cosine of 2 theta d theta. We know that the integral of 1 half is going to be 1 half theta. And the integral of cosine of 2 theta is 1 half sine of 2 theta. And if you didn't see that right away, remember you could have used u substitution, where u equals 2 theta. But hopefully you should be seeing some integrals like that now, right away. So we have 16 thirds times 1 half theta plus 1 half times 1 half is 1 fourth sine of 2 theta. And we need our constant c. So if we multiply through by the 16 thirds, we get 8 thirds theta plus 4 thirds sine of 2 theta plus our constant c. And now we need to switch back to our x's. So we need to solve for theta and sine of 2 theta. So way back up here, we said x is 4 thirds sine of theta. So if we know x is 4 thirds sine of theta, then that means that 3x over 4 equals sine of theta. So the inverse sine of 3x over 4 equals theta. So I found what theta is, but now I need to find what sine of 2 theta is. And I know what sine of theta is, that's 3x over 4, but I don't know sine of 2 theta. What we need to recall is our double angle formula, that sine of 2 theta equals 2 times sine of theta times cosine theta. And we already know sine of theta, so we're just looking for this cosine of theta. So if sine of theta is 3x over 4, sine is opposite over hypotenuse. So drawing our triangle, we have opposite and hypotenuse. So this side here, we'll call it y for now, is going to be 3x quantity squared plus y squared equals 4 squared. So 9x squared plus y squared equals 16. So y squared equals 16 minus 9x squared. Taking the square root, and remember we want the positive half, 16 minus 9x squared is y. And cosine of theta is adjacent over hypotenuse. So that means that it is the square root of 16 minus 9x squared over 4. So now we know what cosine of theta is, we know what sine of theta is, so we're ready to go. We said we know what theta is. Theta is the inverse sine of 3x divided by 4. Thirds times the inverse sine of 3x divided by 4. We said we know one of our stops along the way of converting sine of 2 theta into x was that sine of 2 theta is 2 times sine of theta cosine theta. So times 2. And we know that sine of theta is 3x divided by 4. And we know that cosine We just found was the square root of 16 minus 9x squared over 4. And we have our plus c. So to simplify this, let's multiply some of this stuff over here through. We are going to have 8 thirds inverse sine of 3x divided by 4 plus, we have 4 times 2 times 3, so that's 24 over 3 times 4 times 4, so 16 times 3 is 48. Times x times the square root of 16 minus 9x squared, and plus our constant c. And about the only thing we can do to simplify this is 24 divided by 48 leaves us with 1/2. So our answer is 8/3 inverse sine of 3x divided by 4 plus 1/2. Or x times the square root of 16 minus 9x squared over 2, plus our constant c. And remember that because we have this inverse sine, what's inside this 3x divided by 4 has to be between negative 1 and 1. So that means the x has to be between negative 4/3 and 4/3.